Well, it's 1 p.m. on my workshop. We are celebrating Bloomsday today. It's a day that was described in Ulysses by James Joyce. And I'm sure some of you know that walking through Dublin in very beautiful hats was a thing to do in those days. Therefore, we invited Heather Gray to teach us how to make Bloomsday hats. So without further ado, I will introduce Heather to you. And I would like to mention that if you have any comments or questions, you should use Q&A function on the bottom of your screen. Please also let us know if you cannot hear us well through that Q&A function, so we will make sure that we speak clearly and loudly enough. Thanks very much and enjoy the workshop.
Hello everybody. Welcome to this workshop on how to make a Bloomsday boater hat, which I'm wearing at the moment. So my name is Heather Gray. I'm an artist and I work for the Chester Beatty. And we thought it would be a great idea to make some hats this Bloomsday. Obviously, it's a little bit different from other Bloomsday that have gone before, but hopefully you'll still enjoy today and enjoy making this hat from recycled materials. So I'm going to share a little presentation with you first. And again, if I'm going too fast or if you have any questions, just put it into the Q&A and Justina or Heidi will pass on the message to me and I can repeat the step. So hopefully everybody can see that. So that's just our materials. That's what we'll need today. And I'm just going to tell you a little bit about what we're going to do. So we're using recycled cardboard, cereal box, scissors, masking tape or duct tape, measuring tape and a ruler, and we're gonna make a cardboard hat. And we're doing this to celebrate Bloomsday, which of course is from James Joyce's novel, Ulysses. So hopefully I can. So you might recognize this figure here. So this is Chester Beatty, and he is actually wearing one of these beautiful boater hats that we're going to make today. I assume his is not made from recycled cardboard, but you never know, maybe it was. And this, of course, is the tome that is Ulysses. So I don't know if anyone has read the entire thing. I started reading it a couple of years ago, and I did not finish it, I'm ashamed to say. But hopefully by this time next year, I will have read the whole thing. And if you have read it, do let us know in the Q&A. So Bloomsday is celebrated every year on the 16th of June in honor of this book. And the day is named after Leopold Bloom, who is the central character in the book, in Ulysses. The novel follows the life and thoughts of Leopold Bloom and a host of other characters and Stephen Dedalus from 8 a.m. on the 16th of June 1904, 116 years ago today, through the early hours of the following morning. The novel is considered a masterpiece and is based on Homer's Odyssey. So every day on this every year on this day, people dress in old-fashioned clothes, including the very stylish boater hat that these two lads are wearing out in Dunleary by the Martello Tower in Dunleary. So they're starting their Bloomsday. So this one's a couple of years ago when you didn't have to social distance, unlike today. So celebrations come in many different forms, including eating a full Irish breakfast. That wouldn't be too bad. Readings, performances, and visiting the places and establishments referenced in the book. So that looks like a delicious fry there, hosted by Joyce himself. Thank you very much. So just a little bit about the book and about Bloomsday. Joyce started writing Ulysses in 1914, but he put it aside again to finish his play Exiles. And on this, he wrote to his brother Stanislaus to say he had finished the first episode of Ulysses. After Ulysses was published in 1922, Joyce's friends began to mark the 16th of June as Bloomsday. So that's where it all began. And this is Joyce, the man himself, with his bad eyesight. And then The very first Bloomsday was celebrated in Ireland in 1954, so marking the 50th anniversary of the day in the book, which is 1904. And it was actually celebrated by some other Irish writers, Patrick Kavanagh and Flann O'Brien. So Flann O'Brien is this man here in the hat, and I actually don't know which one is Patrick Kavanagh, but I'm sure some of you can point him out. So on this day, they visited the Martello Tower in Sandy Cove, Davy Byrne's pub, and 7 Eccles Street. And as they did, they read parts of the book, and they got very, very drunk. So good day for them. this is another location in, so this is Sweeney's Pharmacy, just beside Trinity College in Dublin. And today Bloomsday is celebrated not just in Dublin, but all over the world with readings, performances, and other events. This year is a little bit different because activities have moved online, but I hope you'll still enjoy Bloomsday this year and that you'll enjoy making your lovely boater hat. So let's get started. And again, if you have any questions at all while we do this, just put it in the Q&A and I can slow down or we can repeat a step. No problem at all. So I'm just going to move my camera down so that you can see what I'm up to. Now, so the first thing that we're going to do is we want to measure our heads. So you are going to need your tape measure for this part. So hopefully everybody has a tape measure. If you don't have a tape measure, you could use a ruler. It'll just be a little. You don't have a tape measure, but you have some ribbon. You can use the ribbon to tie around the top of your head, and then you can measure that on. So have some. But I'm gonna do it myself. It to be too tight, so maybe an extra centimeter, and then you're gonna see the circumference of your head. So mine is 59 centimeters or 23 inches. And if you've got a couple of people making a hat today, I'll give you a couple of minutes to get your measurements. So once you have that, you can write down your measurement. So mine is 59 centimeters. And what we're going to be doing with our measurement is we're going to be then getting our cereal box and we're going to be measuring 59 centimeters onto our cereal box. So that will be for the inside of our hat. So we have on the inside here, we just have a ring of cereal box cardboard. And that's what we're gonna make now. So it's very simple start. So just get the measurement of your head, circumference of your head. And then once you have that, you're going to get your cereal box. It's a nice flexible cardboard. It's not too thick. And you're just going to cut that flat. And if you have some little people making a hat today, which I'm sure we do, do get an adult to help you to cut out the cardboard or to use the scissors in general, if you're very young. Now. So I have my cardboard cut flat, and now I'm gonna measure my 59 centimeters. So I'll put in my extra centimeter and we'll go to we go to 60. So 60 centimeters circumference. And I'm going to make the width of it, I'm going to make that about 5 centimeters. So it doesn't have to be exact because this is actually going on the inside of your hat. So 5 centimeters. 5 centimeters in thickness, and then however large your head is in width. And of course the cereal box isn't ginormous. Maybe you have a giant piece of cardboard, but mine isn't that big. So we're gonna have to cut it into strips. So I'm just gonna cut 3 strips of 20 centimeters each, and then I'm gonna tape them together with my masking tape. So you can measure down each side, 5 centimeters in height, and then 20 centimeters across, and then however thick your head is, that's how much cardboard you want to go around your head. And I'm sure a lot of you are actually still getting the measurements, so that's perfect, that's fine. No rush today. So I've just used my ruler and pen to mark out the strips of card that I'm going to stick together, and then that's going to go around the circumference of my head. And just in case you've just joined us, so you have not missed very much at all, so all we've done is we have taken our tape measure and we have wrapped it around our head to get the measurement. So wherever your hat would sit. And the measurement I got here was 59 centimeters, which I have rounded up to 60. And then I took note of that, and then I cut out 3 strips of 20 centimeters each, or I've drawn them out, I haven't cut them out yet, but I'm going to cut out these 3 strips and then we're going to stick them together, and that's going to be the band for the top of our hat.
Hey there, sorry to interrupt. There is a question, what if the lines are not cut straight? Can you address that, please?
If the lines aren't cut straight, it's not too much of a problem. Yeah, that's totally fine. So just all you need is this nice bit of cardboard, so it doesn't have to be too straight. So if you don't have a ruler or it's gone a little bit wonky, I wouldn't be worried at all, because this is actually going on the inside of your hat. So no one's going to see this bit. It's more important for the next bits to be cut straight, but this bit, it's fine if it's a little bit wonky.
Thank you.
Okay. Let's see. So I'm going to start, if you're still measuring, that's fine. Once you measure, just cut your strips or draw your strips. So I'm going to start cutting this out now. So I might be a little bit faster than at this than you are. So I'll probably wait for a minute after this. But again, if you are quite young, I'd say if you're under 12, get an adult to help you to cut out the cardboard, because we want anybody cutting their fingers. That wouldn't be great. So I now have my three strips of cardboard here. And all I'm going to do with these is I'm going to connect them like this. Then I'm going to get my masking tape. So, but any tape will do. So you could use sellotape or you could use duct tape. I have this giant roll of masking tape and a smaller one. So I'm just going to use the smaller one to connect up my inner ring for my hat, for my boater hat. So I'm just taping the joins here on one side, and then I'm turning it over and just going to tape the back as well. So I'm just folding over that tape. So it's super strong. So you're taped on both and it's not gonna fall apart. Now, so this is what I have now at the minute. Move that up a little again. So then at this point, you're just going to take that and you're going to fold it around your head. So I said to leave maybe a centimeter or 2 centimeters extra on your piece of cardboard. So now you're actually going to tape it to the exact size of your head. So, and if you have somebody to help you to do this, that would be perfect. So so one person can hold it and then the other person can tape it, or if you're on your own you can also do it like I just did. Yeah, so I'm just taping that on the join just there, and again I'm going to tape the outside and the inside so that it's really strong. That's what we want. This is our base. I'm gonna double tape it to reinforce so it definitely won't fall apart. Yeah. So great. So everybody should have ring of cardboard that can go around your head like so, and it should be a good fit, so snug enough but not too tight. You don't want it too tight. Yeah. And then once you have that, we are going to get our pencil or our pen or whatever device you have for drawing, and this bit, so maybe I'll give it a little minute just to make sure there's no questions or everybody has this bit at this point, hopefully. and then. Okay, so hopefully everyone has the band, and then we're going to put that on your head, and then taking the shape from your head, vaguely, we're going to put that down on our larger piece of cardboard, and we're going to hold it. So again, if you've got two people, that would be a good help. And then all we're going to do here is we're just going to trace around our band.
And just pause for 1 minute, Heather, just so yeah. People need to catch up.
Yeah, no problem. So maybe I'll wait for this bit. This is an important bit. No problem. So I don't know if anybody has ever celebrated Bloomsday before. I'm sure some of you have, and you've probably visited all the lovely places. Some of them you could still visit today, outside, if you're in Dublin, that is. But yeah, none of the indoor places, unfortunately. But a couple of the places that you may not know are in the story would be the Martello Tower out in Sandy Cove. And there's actually a lovely little museum there now dedicated to Joyce. Sandy Mount Strand by the beach. Glasnevin Cemetery on the north side. They're there as well. They're also in the National Library of Ireland. And Grafton Street. If you're in Ireland, I'm sure you've been to Grafton Street. So that's all in the book. And all on this day in 1904. So a long, long time ago. Okay. So hopefully we're all about this stage. I know if there's a couple of family members making hats, you might be a little bit behind, but I'm gonna plow ahead with the next step now anyway. And actually I might use a pen instead of a pencil so you can see clearer what I'm doing. So you're just gonna take your hat, well, the inner bit of your hat, and you're gonna put it around your head, and then you're gonna take it off very carefully and slowly. And then you could get one person to hold it on the cardboard, and you get another person to trace around the circumference of your band. And it doesn't have to be very perfect at all, and don't worry if the thing moves. That's completely fine. Now, so then you can take your band away and you can tidy up your shape a little bit if there's any rough edges. And you should end up with a shape similar to the shape of the top of your head, I hope. And this part here, this is actually going to be the top of your hat. So once we have our outline drawn, then we'll wait a minute for everybody to draw their outline, especially if there's a good few people making hats at the same table. I'm sure it can get crowded. And then we're going to cut that out. So if anybody is ready, we're going to cut out this piece. And that's going to be the top of our hat, okay? And again, if there's any little people, just get an adult to help you with cutting it out. And if you have a cutting mat and you have a scalpel, you can just scalpel this out and it will actually be a lot smoother. But I'm sure most people have a scissors, so I'm gonna just use the scissors to cut this out. We should have an egg shape like this. So that's gonna be the top of our hat. So you can double check, does it still fit? Has your head changed in the past few minutes? Hopefully not. There's something strange going on. So once we have this, then I'm gonna take away this piece of cardboard and I'm gonna get another piece So if you're using all cereal box material, it'll be much quicker and smoother to cut out the cardboard. But if you're using a thicker cardboard, so I'm using a thicker cardboard here, it'll take a little bit longer because it's just a slightly tougher material. So I'm gonna get some more of the same thicker cardboard. And we're going to use this for the sides of our hat. I'm going to cut it a little bit smaller so that I don't knock over the camera. And this is the recycled hat, the recycled boater hat that I made previously. And I thought it was a good height at the time, but I think I'm going to make it a little bit shorter than I did the last time. So this one is, it's about 10 centimeters. So I'm actually going to make it, let's see, 7? Maybe 8 centimeters. So I'm going to go with an 8 centimeters height for my hat. So all I'm going to do now is I'm going to get my ruler, my pen, and I'm going to measure 8 centimeters around. And we know how big to make it as well, because we know that the circumference of my head is 60 centimeters. So I'm going to make it the same size as the top, and the same width as this, or length, sorry. Same length as that. And hopefully everyone is at about the same level now at this point. So I'm just gonna start measuring across. So 20.
Some people are just taking their time cutting out.
Yeah.
Just catching up.
Yeah, no problem. Yeah. So the cutting out the thick cardboard can be quite time consuming. Because it can be super thick. But if you want it to be easier, just use all of the cereal box cardboard. It's much thinner and much faster to cut. Maybe we'll wait a minute. If you're still cutting out the top, that's perfect. Cutting out your egg shape or whatever shape your head happens to be, that's fine. So once you've done that, that's the top of your hat, so you're going to put that to the side. Then you're going to get another piece of cardboard, and then we're going to make the side of the hat. So we're making this bit of the hat now. And I've decided to make mine about 7 centimeters in height, which is about that, so a little bit shorter than my original boater hat. And all I'm doing now is I'm measuring 60 centimeters in length, and then I'm measuring 7 centimeters in height. There's no rush at all. So whatever part you're on, that's completely fine. But if you are ready to start measuring, all you need is your new piece of cardboard, your ruler, and a pen or a pencil, and that's it. And if your cardboard isn't long enough, so Yeah, so usually, so my cardboard isn't long enough either. So I'm gonna measure, so I need 60 centimeters. So this is actually 40 centimeters. And then I'm gonna measure another 20 centimeters here, and I'm gonna stick them together. So just like we did with this bit. So this is actually stuck together in three different places. So don't worry if you don't have the full length of the cardboard. Yeah, it'll still look absolutely fine. And of course we can actually paint these if we want. So if you've got paint at home, you can paint it. You could put in the straw details. You could go very, very detailed on it. Do some like Van Gogh's wicker chair. You could paint wicker hat. That'd be nice. Look like the straw. Or you could paint it whatever way you would like. You could paint a full Irish breakfast on it. That'd be nice. So I'm just measuring this. So I'm going to measure another 7 centimeters up. Now, and then I'm measuring another 20 centimeters across. And just make sure I haven't gone too far out the other side. We don't want too much extra. And yeah, I'm really looking forward to seeing everybody's hat when it's finished. And if you are so inclined, you can take a photo of your hat, or you can take a photo of yourself in the hat celebrating today, and you can send it to us at the Chester Beatty. So you could send it to us on Facebook or Instagram or Twitter, because we'd love to see them. We'd love to see what kind of cool hats that you make, and especially if you add some strange decorations. The stranger the better. So now at the minute, I'm just going to cut out the side of my hat. So I've done all the measurements, 60 centimeters. And now it's time for the tough job of getting through cardboard again. And if you are young enough, definitely get some help with this.
If you can just wait another minute, please, Heather.
Yeah, yep, no problem. So this is super thick cardboard. I think it's actually even thicker than the original one that I had. So yeah, it's quite a tough job to cut through it. So I'm sure a lot of you are struggling right now with your poor hands. And as well, if you have a small scissors, if you've got a small kid's scissors, it can be really difficult to cut through this type of cardboard. So I would recommend either asking an adult to get the scissors from the kitchen, big kitchen scissors, and cut the cardboard, or using cereal box cardboard, because it's much easier. Or maybe you have some other type of, you might have some craft board or something at home that you're using that might be easier to cut as well. And I hope that your hat will inspire you to read Ulysses as well. I mean, I gave up, but I'm sure that you will continue to read it. So a lot of people love the book. I mean, millions of people absolutely adore it, and that's why everyone celebrates Bloomsday on the 16th of June every year. The writer George Orwell was a huge fan, and he said after he read it, he said it made him very depressed because he knew that never write something as good as that. So he was pretty unhappy when he finished the book. And then Virginia Woolf, she read about 200 pages and she gave up, and she was not a fan. So what she said of the 200 pages she did read, she said that it was the work of a queasy undergraduate scratching his pimples. So she was fairly critical of the book. And she also said, never did any book bore me so much. So there is some criticism of it as well. So maybe we have made a little bit of progress there with our cutting, I hope. So in case anyone has joined in late or anything like that, so what we've done so far is we've made a band the size of the circumference of our head using this soft cardboard from a cereal box. We've measured that onto some thicker cardboard to make the top of the hat. And now we are making the side of the hat. So we're making this bit of the hat here. And what I've done is I've just measured here. So this one is 40 centimeters, this one is 20 centimeters. I'm gonna cut them out and I'm gonna stick them together with the masking tape. So I'm gonna continue to do that, but if you have any questions or if you want me to slow down, just let me know. And you can do that in the Q&A box, which is at the bottom of your screen.
Do we know why they hated it?
Well, Virginia Woolf, I think she thought it was very boring. So, yeah, I suppose there's a lot of stream of consciousness in Ulysses, and it can be quite hard to read. And he invented words. He would like stick words together. I guess it's quite hard to understand what he was talking about. So all his books were about Dublin. So he wrote Dubliners, that was his first book. But he actually left Dublin when he was in his early 20s and he never returned. And he died quite young. He died in 1941. So he had a strange relationship with Ireland and a strange relationship with Dublin, because Dublin was the subject of all of his work. But when he wrote everything that he wrote, he wasn't actually here. He was in Paris and Trieste. So he was sort of looking back at Dublin. And maybe with some nostalgia and also with a lot of criticism. So he was quite critical of the society in Ireland at the time. He was critical of British rule and he was critical of the Catholic Church as well. So what I'm doing now is I'm just taping together the side of my hat so that I have 60 centimeters around. And I'm just using my small thing of masking tape. Like so. And for the inside, you can be as messy as you like. So I'm actually going to go across just for strength on the inside. And then I'm going to go around again just for some extra strength. So around the whole thing. So Ulysses is set in 1904. So it's a long, long time ago now at this stage. But at that time in Dublin and in other parts of the world, people wore hats more often than they do now. So most hat. And also people wouldn't wash their hair as often. So yeah, it would have been very, very common to wear a hat, unlike today. But during lockdown, I think people have also not been washing their hair as often. So it's also a good idea to wear a hat at the moment so that no one has to smell your smelly hair. Although lockdown's just about to end. So maybe you need to start washing your hair more often. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so in a lot of old photographs, you'll notice all these different types of hats. And there's a lot of images in the Chester Beatty collection as well, of beautiful, beautiful hats. And I did show you one picture of Chester Beatty in a boater hat, but he had loads of different hats. There's one where he's wearing a huge sombrero style hat. And there's another one that looks a bit like a cowboy hat. So he was a big fan. So I'm sure if he was around today, he'd enjoy this workshop. He'd enjoy making a hat. So I'm just gonna tape this into a circle like so. And again, on the inside, it doesn't matter how messy you are. So you can put lots of tape on the inside, tape on the outside. And the only issue with this hat that I could envisage is the rain. So if it's raining, don't wear this outside because it might just dissolve on your head. And that would not be a good look for sure. So I'm just going to put an extra bit of tape on the outside here. And if anyone has lovely brown masking tape, that would be perfect for this task. I don't have it, unfortunately. And now I'm going to attach the top. I'm going to put the top on here. And this will help with our shape. So the shape of this is a bit wonky at the moment, but we have our lovely egg shape together. So I'm only going to tape from the inside. I'm not going to tape the outside of this so that we'll keep it looking very nice. Of course, if you're going to paint over it though, it doesn't really matter. You can tape outside as well. So I'm just placing this on top and then turning it upside down. And then I'm gonna get my small masking tape. And then I'm gonna tape the inside here. To start with, I'm just gonna tape it in four places. So north, south, east, and west. And then I'll go around and tighten it up, just so that it's even.
Hi Heather, we just have a question about paint. Isn't there some brands of paint that do work on sellotape? Or are there any?
Yeah, there definitely would be. Poster paint probably wouldn't, but anything that's shiny, anything that would, if you had some acrylic, just like a nice acrylic paint, that would go over sellotape. Anything with a bit of shine in it or gloss, wall paint. The watercolor won't work, definitely not. And poster paint, because it's quite watery as well, won't work. And also, if you have the chalk paints, they won't work either. But acrylic paint will definitely work. Or even if you have watercolors, just don't dilute them and paint with them directly. You'd probably need a lot for one of these. Yeah, but another option apart from paint is you could actually get paper. So you could cover the whole thing in a paper. So you wouldn't need to paint it at all. Yeah. So if somebody's at the paint stage at the moment, I'm very impressed. That's pretty good. So I've just taped it in four places and now I'm gonna put a bit more tape on the inside. Just gonna go around the inside like so and just keep taping at kind of like evenly spaced taping so you don't go too mad in one place. And you can keep going, you can tape the entire thing if you like, or if you think it's secure enough at this stage, if you think you have enough tape on the inside, then that's fine. So I'm just going to put in a little bit more. There. So that's what the inside of my hat looks like. And as I said, you can keep going. You can fill in all these spaces with tape if you want. But I'm going to leave mine like this. I don't think it needs any more. And then I'm going to go on to the next stage. So the next bit. So what I'm going to do now is I need another piece of cardboard, another bit of not necessarily thick cardboard, but just another piece of flat cardboard. So I think this piece is actually even thicker, it'll be tougher, even tougher to put through. But again, if you're using cereal box cardboard, it's much, much easier. Now, so I have my extra piece of cardboard, I have my hat. So now we need to decide. So you can decide yourself how big you want the brim to be. So how big did I make this one the last day? So this one is 3.5. So if you want the brim to be about this size, this is 3.5 centimeters in width. Or maybe you want it to be bigger. Maybe you want to have like a giant brim on it to keep out the sun, keep the sun out of your eyes. So you could make it however big you like. So maybe 5 or even 10. So I think I quite like this. So I'm gonna go a little bit bigger. I'm gonna go 4 centimeters around. So first of all, put your hat in the middle, then get your pencil or pen, and then we're going to trace around the hat again. Yeah. So I fully traced around the hat, and hopefully you can see that. It's a little bit bright. But again, it's our egg shape, our oval shape. And now we're gonna get our ruler. You could use your tape measure either. So I'm gonna get my ruler and then I'm gonna go, so make sure you have enough room on your piece of cardboard. I'm gonna go 4 centimeters out from the line that I traced. And again, I'm gonna do it by doing north, south, east, and west, and then I will keep going around. So that was north. So essentially you're just marking 4 centimeters or 3 or 10, however big you want the brim to be, from the line that you have marked here. So now I'm just going around a little bit like with the masking tape. So I'm just going around and I'm marking 4 centimeters from the outline of our hash. And I'll probably end up with about 20 or so little marks. But you could have less, or you could have more. You could have 100, but probably about 20 marks is fine. And it doesn't have to be perfect. So I'm gonna do one more. Okay. So I have my egg shape here, and then hopefully you can see the marks that I've made here, and then I'm just going to connect them up. So just using my eye, I'm just going to round them. So I'm trying to get the same shape as this. So I'm just going to connect up the dots. And again, it doesn't have to be perfect at all. So don't worry if you've got scribbles or you're doing wrong or anything. It doesn't have to be perfect. There. Okay, so you should have this sort of toilet seat shape on your cardboard now at this stage. And then all we're gonna do once we have that shape is we're just gonna cut it out. So again, you can use, if this is an adult making the hat, you could use a scalpel, be very quick. And if you are a young person, maybe get an adult to help you and use a large scissors and get an adult to help to cut it out. Okay. And then, so all your leftover materials, all the scrap from cutting out your hat, it's all recyclable stuff. So remember to put it into your recycling bin. Unless you want to make something else out of it, of course. And so one of the pictures that I showed you there was all the people out celebrating Bloomsday a couple of years ago, and they all threw their hats up in the air for the photo. So that would be great if you can get a picture of you in your homemade cardboard hat, and then you can throw it up in the air and try and get a picture. That would be really cool. And then you can send it to us on Facebook or Instagram or Twitter, because we'd love to see what you've made. This is a very thick cardboard. Now, so I've cut around the outside, and now is the hard part. How are we gonna cut the middle? Does anybody know? So how did we do it last time? So this is definitely not for kids to do. This is definitely for an adult to do. So if you have a scalpel, you can just scalpel around here. That's easy enough, but if you have scissors, get an adult to help you to do it. And you're just gonna stab a hole in the middle. so that you have somewhere to start your cut. There. So I've just put the scissors through the middle, and then I'm going to cut to my inside line here. And don't worry if you're still at an earlier step. Yeah, no rush. Or if you need anything repeated, just let me know. So I'm just cutting this into four sections, like a pizza. So I'm doing that first from my central stab mark. And then we're just gonna cut these out. So I'm just gonna cut around the line there. So it should be a lot easier to cut. And then one more slice of pizza to go. And again, it doesn't have to be perfect at all. We're taping over the edges. So rough edges are welcome. That's fine. And then you should have this shape cut out. So now we're gonna move our scrap material out of the way. We're gonna place this down here. Going to place our hat here, and then I am going to turn it over like so, and then I'm going to tape it here. So you can use any kind of tape that you have at all. I'm going to use my smaller masking tape, and again you're just going to go north, south, east and west for the first taping. And then again, here you can actually add as much tape as you like. A little bit more. Just tighten up the hat. And if you do have sellotape or this type of clear sellotape particularly, that's good for this bit. If you haven't started with masking tape yet. So then I'm just taping in a circle, just tightening it up, making sure there's no gaps where the sun can come in and blind you. There. So then I'm going to use a line of tape on the edge as well. Could possibly use the big one either if you have that. Use the small one. I'm just going to go around the inside like so. The great thing about masking tape, if you put it in the wrong place, you can just take it off again. Great. So I'm just putting that on the inside and then I'm gonna fold it over. So then we definitely won't have any gaps at all. And I'll do the same on this side. So just one last bit here. And fold it over. Cool. So everyone, you'll soon have, or you might already have, a hat. Quite messy on the inside, but beautiful on the outside. So for the last piece, what we're gonna do is if you have some ribbon, some black material, or any color material really, even some tape, if you had some colored tape, or what else could you use? Shoelaces, anything at all, or an old t-shirt that you could cut up. We're just gonna get a strip of material to put around the middle of the hat, and then our boater hat is nearly finished once we do that. So I have some black material here. And we know that the circumference of my head is 60 centimeters, quite a large head. So I'm just gonna measure 60 and then I'm gonna add another 20. So I'm just gonna measure about 80 centimeters. It doesn't have to be perfect at all. And then I'm gonna cut a strip, which is, we'll say 10 centimeters in width, and then I'm gonna fold it over, and that's gonna be tied around my hat. So once you have measured, just take your scissors and cut a straight line. At approximately 10 centimeters in width. Yeah. So you can just run your scissors down through the material and then you should end up with something like this. And then I'm gonna fold this over a few times. Let's see. So I've folded mine in three so that I have a piece of material about this size. Maybe I'll fold it even smaller. There. And then you're just gonna wrap that around the front of your hat. And then you might need, if you have two people, this would be a good time to get some help. You can get somebody to hold the material at the back while you tie a knot. You can get them to put their finger on the back material and then you tie a knot at the back like so. And then that is your basic boater hat. So that's your hat absolutely and utterly finished. But if you want, you are welcome to add decoration. So you could draw on it or you could paint it. And you could also, so I've made a couple of, so more recycling, a couple of recycled flowers from toilet roll tubes. So if you wanted to make one of these, all you do is you cut a toilet roll tube into five and then you tape it in the middle. So I've just put some tape in the middle. So you could even, you could add some flowers onto your hat as well. And whatever you do with it, we would love to, we'd love to see the finished piece. So I wonder, does anybody need anything repeated, or does anyone have any questions at all? And if not, let's see now. Or even if you have some feathers at home, you can put feathers into the front of your hat, which would be just lovely. So you can just slip the feathers in under the brim of your material. And so that is your boater hat. And yeah, we would love to see what you have made. So do send us a picture or even a video if you'd like to. So thank you so much for joining us today. My name is Heather Gray, and thanks to the Chester Beatty for inviting me to do this hat workshop. I hope everyone has made a successful hat.
I will definitely need to have some extra help with mine, because I wasn't able to follow everything. But yes, thank you so much, Heather. Thank you for making the hat. And I hope everybody will actually take them out for a walk, whatever is the closest, as you mentioned, maybe Sandy Mount Strand or Martero's Tower in Sandy Cove or Grafton Street even, maybe. You can showcase your beautiful hat to the doorman at the Bram Thomas. They always have really nice ultra hats. give them some competition. Thank you everybody for joining us again, and we will have some more workshops in July. So you're very welcome to have a look at our website in the coming days. I would like to thank Heather for making this session such a great success. Thank you again, and we'll see you shortly, hopefully in the Chester Beatty.
Yes, I hope so. Thank you, everyone. Thank you. Bye.